Hi, I'm Tom with Pulse and Cascade Tackle, and today we're going to show you how to build a spinner using a TwisTech wire forming tool. The TwisTech is a tool that was designed for the do-it-yourselfer to be able to make perfect loops to build spinners, spreaders, and what have you, and it's a very simple process. Always begin with the handle parked over the left rail of the TwisTech. Put your wire in between those two pins and catch the wire with the groove on the bending finger. Push it on around the tall pin, and then you kink the big shaft over against the short pin. You notice this is almost back over the left rail again. And then you'll have a on-center loop to begin with. At this point, you can put a hook on or a swivel or anything else that you want to do. Lay that into what we call the twisting hook and into this forming die. And you simply, with a little pressure to the left, wind that up until it's all used up. You point that to the sky, and then there's your hook on the wire. In today's situation, we're going to use some hook tubing on this, and the hook tubing we're using is called Easy Tube. And Easy Tube is a little different than some of the other hook tubings in that it's a little more flexible, but it's still not rubber. It is indeed a plastic. So we work that down over the eye of the hook and the wire shaft. Now, I like to put another bead down inside that tube just to keep it centered up on the wire. In this case, we're using a 5mm bead, and we just push it down the wire and send it right inside the top of that tube. And that'll help keep that all centered up nice and pretty. The next thing we do is assemble our bead stack. The bead stack becomes the body of your lure, and it does two things. It serves as additional attraction, and it helps position the hook the right distance from the end of the blade. I'm going to put on 3 number 6 beads, then I'm going to put on a number 3 little plastic bead to serve as a bearing surface. And on top of that, we put on a solid brass bearing bead just to make the blade swing even better. The blade we're using today is a Wise Guy 3.5. Very popular blade for trolling for salmon and other things. We're going to stick a clevis through the eye. Then we thread this through both eyes of the clevis. Give it a little spin, make sure it's all working right. Now we're going to come over and repeat that first process you saw. We extend this between these two pins about the distance of the width of your thumb. If you want more wraps, you can stick it out farther. If you want less, a little less extension. Bring it over, kink it over, make sure it's on center. When it's on center, you cross it back over here to this side and wind it up just like we did the first part. And there you go, a perfectly done 3.5 spinner in this case. Some people may ask why the extra wire length. Well, that's a matter of personal preference. I like to be able to twist it back and forth like this and fidget with the hook to make sure it's in perfect alignment. We call that tuning the spinner. To get that spinner tuned up perfectly, then the whole thing will troll more perfectly. And that's how you do it with a TwisTech.